A safety alert for anyone who uses those detergent pods and who have small children in the house. The Consumer Product Safety Commission is warning parents to keep those pods out of reach of children. They are highly toxic and have caused severe injuries in children who've ingested them. Susan Hogan joins us this morning with a warning that everybody should hear about.
You know, I have done this story a couple of times, and it's one of those things where you feel some people might zone out like, oh, come on, we've heard about this.
Yeah.
But you know what? Time and time again, children are getting injured from these things. And just on August 9th, a little boy in Florida, he was a 9-month-old baby, died after ingesting one of these pods. Now, his death has not been 100% confirmed that it happened because of ingesting this. However,
right.
With the scenario and all, and according to the police report, the baby was lying on a bed and the little pod packet was right beside him. He woke up, reached over, was sucking on this when his mom walked in the room, brought him to the hospital immediately where he did die. So all things point to that this pod may have been, you know, the actual cause of this little baby's death. If this is confirmed, it will be the very first of its kind in the United States. But that doesn't mean that other children have not been injured.
Right, yeah. So there may have been other children injured in it.
Oh, there are.
You know, you see these
right.
things and they look, you know, they look like candy.
Right.
And to a little kid, you're going to grab one of the real mints or
exactly.
one of these. It's easy to see why they would do it.
It truly is. I mean, they're so tempting to children. I mean, they're squishy.
Yeah.
They smell really good. They look really good.
Mm-hmm.
And especially if you're a baby and someone who's teething, you know, this is one of those perfect little things to gnaw
to
on.
To grab onto.
Exactly. And they're so highly toxic, Will, that's what happens is when they come in contact with water
mm-hmm.
or saliva, they begin to break down. So then they pop, and then they'll, you know, you can ingest these things fairly
okay.
quickly. And thousands of children do. In 2012, more than 6,200 children were exposed to
wow.
these kinds of pod packets. Now, come forward now to January of 2013 to July
mm-hmm.
31st of this just last month.
Right.
Over 5,200 children, 5,700 children were exposed to these things. So we're talking that kids are getting, babies, little toddlers are getting their hands on these
pods.
Things. And here's the thing, too. We're talking about, you know, we're not picking on any one particular
right.
company because a lot of them make them. Tide is redesigning its packaging to make sure that kids have a little bit harder time getting into
the packet
actual
itself,
packet
right.
itself. And the detergent, believe it or not, the dishwashing detergent is actually more toxic than the laundry detergent.
Okay.
Okay, we keep talking about laundry detergent, but these little packets for the dishwashing detergent are almost even more toxic.
Is that because it may have like a bleach substance in it or something like that to sterilize
well,
the...
Well, it's actually more compact, and if you feel it, so there's more of a concentration.
Oh, yeah,
they're
there
highly,
is.
Yes, they're highly concentrated with the packets.
Wow.
And a couple of things that, as parents, you should know, if your child ingests any of this detergent, whether it's the laundry detergent or dishwashing detergent,
yep.
some of the signs and symptoms that you really need to be aware of is almost immediately they will have vomiting.
Okay.
Okay. Other things like severe stomach upset, respiratory issues. It has gotten to the point where some children actually have had to be intubated because of the respiratory issues as well. There, as I said, there are concentrated toxic chemicals
mm-hmm.
in these things, and you know, a moment they're touching with saliva or with water,
yeah, yeah.
they will explode. So, you know, if the Poison Control Association cannot stress enough that if your children, if they're near it and they've had it and it's on their mouth and you can smell it, you need to call Poison Control immediately.
Don't wait.
And get help. Don't wait. No.
Man, it's one more thing the parents have to worry about.
Of course.
It's
yeah,
crazy stuff, but good information.
Sure.
Thanks so much for all of this information. And we have much more information. Yes, there is more on our website. It's WPRI.com.